Hello, everybody. Everybody, every person. What's up today? It's a nice day. It's Shabbat day. It's no judging day. It's a be happy day for everybody. Everybody that managed to be happy, try. Don't judge everything. At least we have some moral, something like moral. We are intuitively reflecting on different aspects. I think people need normality. It's what is lacking today. I felt this many years ago, this sense of abnormality, this distancing to myself, more or less every morning I woke up. I had a very odd and rare sense of what's the reality today, what's gonna happen today. What is up? What is life all about? So when I did this ordinary work at some kind of factory. One was F-16. They produced F-16 engine parts, shafts, blades, turbines, and so on. I had a very profound sense of why am I here? Am I doing this? After a while I worked at a paint factory. I felt exactly the same. Why am I here? What am I doing here? It gave no really sense of belonging, not sense of believing in the birth I did. The life was waking up early in the morning. If you can reach to work, you were happy, lucky. And during the workday, we did our stuff, but that was it. And here we are, admiring people for what they are doing. I had a high admiration for people that worked normal, but I couldn't do it myself. I was really baffled by how people could continue day in and day out. I had no inspiration, I had no stamina to do this kind of labor. I thought to myself, what is this? What is this kind of work? And every time I had this interaction with people, either it was a church meeting where we could attend with testimonies. I did that. You see, when I was at the age of 11, I was filled with the Holy Spirit. And ever since, I had this void within me. What is this? Void? What is this void? I felt emptiness and nothing did really work. But every time I did this testimonial, God is good, I'm so glad I'm saved, you must be saved, and so on, this is the best, pow! It was really something profound that I was tapped into. It was very out there. To be tapping into this kind of non-activity like labor, ordinary labor, you work hard, did your, when you came from work, yeah, filled up with, no, it was me, it was a stepping down all the time. I got so sensitive to my body's responses, I couldn't stand it anymore. But when I was attending the church, I was prepared for a testimony. And I was also nourishing from the empty void I felt when I was in ordinary labor. I used this empty void thing. I wasn't aware of it. I know now, after some years, 40 years, that it was all about emptiness, void, and it gave me the incidents, the happening when I was living back then was a nourishment to my testimonies. So I did some testimony, I led in prayer, I opened the meeting like introduction to the meeting, and what to say? It was the void that maybe that void, I thought that void would be obvious for people when I moved to Sandefjord, from Kongsberg to Sandefjord, but they didn't see it. They didn't see the void. I think that the void here I'm talking about is the profundity of the human spirit connected with the void itself, God. So people are materializing God, which is so wrong. God is within the particles of the void. I can't believe that people are they are making God as to be an object of some material. I think the God is so much bigger, it's so much profound. It's beyond our comprehension because we relate everything to materialistic reality. That is the reality. But When I did this ordinary labor, I couldn't find my way. But when I was attending the church with some personal activity, wow, that was way up the steps. That was the inspiration. I was also attending some youth community. We called it the Teens Gathering. It was the name, Tentriff. And after it was boiled, it never came back. It was like persons are separating each other. He is good, he is bad. He is popular, he is not popular. All this kind of bullshit. At this teen gathering, I was exploring my spiritual identity. It was like I was born filled with the Holy Spirit out when I was in Kenya. But when I came to Norway after the second period, I knew that I had a testimony in my heart, and I had a sense of calling or sense of drive, let's call it a drive, that was to be of some. I found some kind of identity which you have to obey. You can't handle with it in a, but this identity is some kind of like your own personality. You can't really go deep into it without getting confused, but it is there, and you have to be obedient to that kind of identity. It's God-given. It's when people are talking about my identity, it's either you are a believer or not. It is God-given. It's beyond yourself. It's you can't define your identity in a way that makes sense on some level, but you have to admit to it. It's you, and some people believe that your identity is changing over time. No. I don't believe in the change of identity. Your identity is your trademark. It's you. It's this. Every person have its own pattern. So that is your trademark. Your identity is just what it is. And when you are filled with the Holy Spirit, you are not only promoting, but you are confirming that God gave you this identity. What is it about? It's about the connection. It's about relationship. So if you are out there thinking that you have identity, and you don't interact with people, and you don't How strange should it be that a spiritual that you with your spiritual identity is way beyond others? No, you are more realistic. You are more appearance with everybody else. And it's partly you confirm your own identity, but you also confirm others. I don't go around destroying people's identity. I just want to confirm it. Listen to this identity crisis. I take a pause.
Yes.
Sometimes we are disturbed and we have to relocate. Anyway, you can't stop. And if you stop, you are tampering with your soul. Your personality is all about your soul. Don't lose it. I think the soul word is a way different, slightly different from the personality, the word of personality, the true meaning. So it's when you are filled with the Holy Spirit, it is within your personality. It's not nothing. It so when I was doing this kind of church thing, and also when I was talking with people about God and about those things back then, it gave me a sense of meaning, importance. I could say something about God, but some people brought major arguments that was profoundly very good. One man told me that God gave these commandments, and all the commandments is good, but it's good because it's you are the God. You shall have no other God than me. I'm the God. You are the most important person in the world, and I couldn't deny, I couldn't dispute these kind of wordings. I thought he was far out, but in fact, he had some good arguments to it. And after many years, I learned a little bit about how to reflect around God. I found out that to talk about God is something, this is quite annoying. Anyway, to talk about God is like talking about yourself. It's not really that nice. You don't want to talk about your friend when nobody is, when your friend is not there. But we can in fact talk about God because we believe he is here. But I don't think it's good to talk about God as I know God and so on. No, because it doesn't level up the non-believer and believer. It's like the believer have every good argument, it doesn't even need to prove. So that does a lot of difference. You can't talk about God like you know it all. No, we are normal human being. You can call yourself a bishop, pope, prophet or whatever you can call yourself. I don't care about those titles. It's just for bragging. It's for self-importance. And who want to talk about self-importance when you are talking about God? That is destroying the whole idea. If you are talking about God, you should be of non-importance. And you have no credit. No one have any credit to talk about God. the God, you either believe or you don't. Either you serve or you don't. You can't talk about something like that. It's beyond you. It's beyond everybody else. You can't define. The first moment you're defining God, you are making a golden calf. You are making a object of worship because of your words. Your words is creating this kind of God. I don't believe in that kind of God. The best God is the void. You can't define it. You are only a servant and a believer. And you can't not believe in the one you are serving. So either you are serving God or you are serving something else. So to keep connected, to keep the relationship with God is to keep connected and relationship with everybody around you. And to not talk about the relationship and mind the relationship. How far are you, have you gone away? If you say you are serving God, but you left the relationship with your brother, your sister, and everybody, who will believe that you are serving God? Well, the God is reminding you of those tiny importance, the tiny bits that you feel is not important. It's all about work, what you can achieve. All this kind of stuff is also something that will boost your image. It's all about yourself. Many people are fooled and lured into this kind of traps that if they do this and that, they will be so great. No, it's just boosting your own image. Everybody likes that. Even me. If people like what I do, it's boosting my image. I'm not naive to those kind of things, but it's a trap. If you think God is all about your image, wow, you are in fact lost. Let me eat this fish. It's sour fish. Wow. So what to say? As long as I am here, I want to keep connected with the void. I have no plans. All is in the void. What is it? Can't you take a order? I would take every order. I would humble myself to take any order and to be with my daughters. Their word is my command. Their word I have to follow. So I'm not arrogant in that kind of sense that I follow the void. I try to listen to what's the important stuff. Is it all what I can do? Renovate my house? Do every everything, I should. Yeah, it's also that, but don't be fooled. Everything that makes your image boost is a distraction. So, after all these years, I don't know what to say, but I felt along the way that to follow your drive, to leave it up to the void, to leave it be in the void, so to say, it's catching up to you. If you serve it well, if you do it well, not regarding other people, you have to be as sharp as a knife, hard as a diamond, but soft as the heart is, in order for it to pump. You can't pump blood with a diamond. That is just brain dead stupid. So, when you are filled with the Holy Spirit, you can go around the world. You have a message. You have something to say. You have some idea that you want to conquer the world. It's not any more you that is in focus. It's the idea. It's how things are, how to meet other people, how to relate to other people. Some people you need to listen to, some people you need to talk to, some people you have to put your finger up to, some people you are humbled with, because they have gone through so much in life that you can't say anything. As those that met a job, they didn't say anything because they knew partly what he was going through. But they broke it in the end. But we people break it in the end. We are never that perfect. So to stay happy, to stay intact with your innermost heart, is partly being a diamond, partly being a heart, ever-flowing stream of rejuvenation. We are seeds. Look at yourself as a seed for those ideas that you have. A seed for your ability to connect to other people. A seed for your experience. So have a good day, my friends. I wish you all the best, and I hope that you succeed. Bring out the void to everybody and let people be fulfilled. Not for achievement in materialistic regard, but to achieve, to live in the void, to be obedient to the void, and that is not time bound, it's beyond time. You are just connected. Okay, Shabbat Shalom.